Hey, Daniel from Behringer with another quick video showing you how the Crave can be way more than just a semi-modular synth. In this video, I wanted to show you how you can use the Crave's alternate MIDI channels to send two separate MIDI tracks in your DAW via the Crave and control both the Crave and an external synth or sound module independently over MIDI. In my previous video, I showed how the Crave can be connected as a USB MIDI interface between your DAW and hardware synths via MIDI and CV gate. I've linked the video below. You're going to want to check that one out first so you can make sure that you have everything set up correctly so you can follow the steps in this video. Before we send out our MIDI data from our DAW, we're going to want to make sure that our Crave and our external synth are communicating on the correct MIDI channels. To change MIDI channel on the Crave, we would generally use the dip switches on the rear of the unit. In this instance, we're going to keep it to MIDI channel 1, so all of our switches are in the down position. However, the external synth, the sound module that we're going to want to control over MIDI, we're going to want to switch that to MIDI channel 2. So in this instance, I'm using the Pro 1, and it's got the same setup where you've got the dip switches, and as you can see here, they're switched to channel 2. Now that we have our MIDI channel set up correctly, we're going to want to make sure that everything's wired up so that it's talking to each other right, and we've got our audio being sent back into our DAW. So here we have the audio out of the Crave, which is going into channel 1 of the audio interface. The audio out of the Pro 1 is coming out of the rear, and that's going to be going into our channel 2 on the audio interface. We have our MIDI out of the Crave going into the MIDI in on the Pro 1. And most importantly, we have our USB connected to our computer where our MIDI data is being sent from the DAW to the Crave and then onto our module, in this case, the Pro 1. So, providing you followed the setup instructions from my previous video, we can now go ahead with creating two MIDI tracks and also two audio tracks within our project. And in this case, I'm using Ableton, but as per my last video, you can use any DAW to do this. So I've renamed our channels so things are a bit more clear as to what's going on. So this is our first channel, our MIDI channel going to the Crave, and we're going to set the output to Crave. And that's on MIDI channel 1. So this is our channel to control the Crave's own internal sound. Here's our second MIDI channel, and this is the one we're going to route via the Crave, but to channel 2, and that's going to control the Pro 1. And here are our audio returns, so that's just simply an audio signal coming from the Crave back into the audio interface, and same with the Pro 1, that's just to allow it to capture the audio into Ableton. I've already recorded my MIDI parts. The first track there in yellow is what's going to be sent to the Crave, which is on MIDI channel 1, and this is the Crave's own internal sounds. Our second channel, the green channel, is the MIDI being sent to the Crave, but it's triggering on channel 2, which is controlling the Pro 1 separately. And now let's record both the tracks at the same time. Now take this one step further and we can apply audio effects to each audio channel. So let's start with, say, a reverb and maybe some delay, and let's just see how it changes the sound. So I hope that gave you a good idea as to how flexible the Crave can be and how good it sounds. Drop a comment below, let us know what sort of content you want to see next. Give us a like, subscribe, and yeah, see you on the next video. I'm Dan from Behringer. Thanks for watching.